I paid $30 for a drink.
Oh!
I paid $30 for a drink. Good morning. It's the summertime. And guess what? I woke up hot. I woke up hot. There's no AC thing. Ooh-wee, it's not for the week. It's not for the week. But anyway, my name is Mark Aquila. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new, go ahead, give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel. Y'all know this like the little weekly vlog. I'm trying to see what do I even have planned this week. It's still Pride. Still. Like, I feel like Pride has... I'm prided out. But I know I'm going to a Pride event this week. And what else? Oh, my friend's friend invited me. So she's like a big, like, author, writer, influencer type situation. She asked me to be a part of her campaign that she has with this brand. So I'm going to be helping out with that. I think I'm going to just be kind of, I guess, kind of like a model, a little, like an extra, whatever, in the video. This is going to, I think she said it's an Instagram reel. So that's exciting. Thank you again for that, girl. What else? I don't know. Y'all know. I just be with the vibes. I don't really have too many other plans, I don't think. But I guess we'll see what we get into. I'll see y'all in a minute. I gotta cool off. Okay, y'all. I know I'm all over the place. Okay, so basically, long story short, we got a gift card to just get, you know, a little bit of merchandise from the store. So that's what we were doing. And then I think we're supposed to be shooting on... I'm tired. Whoa. Not out of breath, child. Whew. I think we're filming on Tuesday. Like, it's for, like, an Instagram reel. And I think it's just so cool. Like, y'all. It's cute. And we're going to be, like, hiking. So, it's going to be, like a little hike thing. I'll probably get some footage for y'all to see. That's what I'm doing. I'm finna go home and get something to eat. Who finna cook? Ain't no food in the house. And the crazy part is, it's food in the house. It is food in the house. But, like, this week... I took a break off. I took a week off from cooking. I'm going to start back cooking next week. I'm actually going to order some groceries because I'm going to get back on keto. And this ain't no health care channel. It ain't no fitness channel. I ain't no fitness guru. But I do notice that when I eat keto, because I think I might have a little bit of like a gluten thing. When I'm keto and pretty much just doing like protein and vegetable, I feel like I do feel a little bit better. Like, because right now I'm just feeling real bloated, real clogged, real, it's not giving. But yeah, but up until then, because I think I'm going to start that on Sunday, or technically probably Monday. Monday, I'm going to start keto fresh on Monday. I'm going to get some rice. I'm going to get some Chinese food. I'm going to get some Chinese food right now, though. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. That's what I'm about to do.
Okay, so I'm trying to learn how to Vogue, but like I got a question, like a real question.
I get the and hold that pulse for me, boom, I can get here. Okay, I can get here. Now the question is, how do y'all go from here to pussycat and hold that pulse for me, bang, you know? I don't think I can do it.
I got got yesterday. I paid $30 for a drink.
Oh!
I paid $30 for a drink. But it was good though. I had a good time. The bar was super cute. It was just so freaking packed in there. We should have came on time. Cause me and my friend, like, we had showed up around like, so the doors open at 10:30. We probably got in around like 11. Bitch, no seats. ignore this, because y'all know I'm always on a skincare journey. I'm always trying to figure out what I could do for my skin. But literally, we got there. It was no seats. It was super crowded. It was super hot. So we kind of just peeked in, peeked out, because we couldn't breathe. But it was super cool. It was super cool. And it's cool that, like, you know, there was a pride event. And I was able to be around. Yeah, I know. I always get on this soapbox, but I just love being around other Black people, especially like after the week I had. I just been feeling like being at that intersection of Black and queer and feeling very isolated. So going to the bar, I just felt everybody's energy, and it just made me feel like, you know what? We are here. We are resilient, and we out here getting it out the mud regardless of society. So that was a good, wholesome feeling. I want my money back for the drink. Low key, the drink was good. It did get me. I got what I needed to get last night. I'm not going to lie to you, but I went against my moral compass and paid $30 for a drink. Okay, y'all. So it's been a day. So last minute, one of my friends ended up getting an extra ticket for the Pride Festival. So I'm on the way to the I'm on the way there now. I just got dressed. Y'all, I done got on the internet and convinced myself that I should try to wear a crop tank top. So that's what we got on. Bam. You know what I'm saying? That's what we got on. Given I put some of those on there and I put some right there. Because the one that I tried to buy, they didn't give it to me. I had ordered it from Target and they pretty much said out of stock. Yeah. After I had already paid for it. So I guess we'll see. You gotta do it how you do it. Do it like it's your B-day, in the words of Jocelyn Hernandez. And so I'll see y'all at the festivities. First of all, who eat these? That's it though. Okay, so they really giving out free snacks and stuff. They gave us this whole box and that whole box. I'm gonna go. So like, oh, and free vitamin water, sponsored by God. First of all, hold on. Y'all know I'm I'm screaming. Oh, update. Update, LA Pride was super cute. It was super fun. It was so big. Like, it was literally like a festival. I'm not gonna lie to you. So like I said, my friend got me a ticket. One of their friends, job gave them extra. And so I was like, I mean, fuck it, I might as well go. For free? Yes, 10 out of 10. Would I have paid for it? It was a lot of stuff, but honestly, probably not, no. Because the tickets was like, if I would have got the $45 tickets, yes, I would have paid for it. But I got the $80. By the time it was time for us to pay for it, it would have been $80 because we missed the first two tiers. For $80, no. But it was cute, though. It just really wasn't anybody that I cared for real, on the stage. The only people that I saw said, I miss Chica. Bob the Drag Queen was cool, but like, I don't know, not for $80. If I would have got the original tickets for $45, yeah. It was cute, and it was like so big. There were so many vendors. There were so many activities. You know what? I ain't even gonna lie to you. I didn't wanna pay $80. Because it wasn't nobody that I really just cared for. Like, for real, for real. But if you had to pay $80, it was, I think it was worthwhile. $45 would have been better. But I said all this to say, y'all, I done got on the wrong train. So now I'm sitting here waiting because I wanted to leave a little bit earlier so that it would be like, you know what I'm saying? I would miss some of that traffic trying to get on the train. But I got on the wrong train. So now I'm sitting here waiting. Child. I'm in Azusa, Heritage Square. I'm in Heritage Square. This ain't nowhere near where I need to be. Just rhyme. This is about the third stop down. Then I just so happen to look up. I'm like, oh yeah, that's the wrong one. You supposed to be going, you supposed to be going south. You going north, baby. But overall, good night. I done got home. Don't get on the train. Don't do it. Don't get on the train. Because, bitch, it'll leave you stranded. And it start doing stupid stuff. Like, after about, I think after 9 o'clock, just don't, I'm done. It got super creepy. I ended up walking home. It was only like, it was like a 30-minute walk. I elected. I wanted to do it. Because I could have still waited for the train. But I was like, you know what? It's too much going on. So, y'all saw, I made the first mistake. I got on the wrong train. I ended up getting on the right train. Everything's going good till we get to where I was supposed to transfer at. And when I got to the transfer spot, they talking about, it was pretty much this whole single tracking thing. But it wasn't, and it was like an upstairs and a downstairs. And there were no signs to specify which train was going to where. Like, it'll just be a train coming. And you kind of just had to, like, either be in... You just had to be in the right space because you don't know which one. I missed the first one and I missed the second one. I could have waited 20 minutes, but at that point... Because I was going up and down the stairs because the escalator was broke. Okay, didn't even let y'all know that. Basically, the escalator was broke. So, I'm having to go upstairs... downstairs trying to go in between the two different trains. I asked one of the people, they talking about something, they think, and I'm like, okay. Walked home, phone died. I liked it. I got disconnected, and on my walk from where I was, like I said, so it was like a 30-minute walk, I end up bumping into like this random little, it was the A-Line Hotel, and I guess like they were having like a drag show party. So cute, hung out in there. Then I walked on, and it was cool. I didn't have a problem with it. But let me tell you something, and this might be too personal, but I want a blunt. So, I'm going to try to teach myself how to roll tomorrow. I don't know how to roll. Never knew how to roll. I'm going to try tomorrow, though. I bought one on my walk home.
I'm so proud of myself because guess what? I did it. I ain't going to show y'all it, but I watched a video on YouTube and I literally got to rolling and I rolled it up. I did it. We did it.
We did it, Joe. I would just like to give a shout out to YouTube. I would like to give a shout out to my ancestors. I feel like this is such a big accomplishment for me, because if y'all know anything about me, I never knew how to roll. I never knew how to do that. That was something that I never knew how to do. I never knew how to roll, and I never knew how to use like that big lighter, the one that you have to like round up. I always had to use an electric one. I think I talked to y'all recently about how I learned how to use the electric one. I mean, I learned how to use the like the standard lighter, and now I know how to roll. It's just giving very much so, like, growth is giving. I don't know. I just feel very accomplished. I feel very accomplished about this. Like, I'm never knew how to roll. I always would have to just ask my friend to do it, or I would just, you know, use the little device thing. Wow. All right, let me go. Let me enjoy the fruits of my labor. I'll talk to y'all. Did I vlog today? No. Did I have a good day? Yes. Was I all in the city like a city girl? Yes. Because that's me. That's my life. I really had a good day today. I met somebody new. And I was really at the point where I was done meeting these LA bitches. Like, for real, for real. I was done. I wasn't trying to meet nobody else. And, I mean, just like on the friend shit, you know. But, like, still, just the part of meeting somebody. I was done. I had been super showed off, closed off. I had been super closed off to it because I had just been meeting weird people, like back to back, like vibes just weird. You coming on too strong, like what are you doing, back up? Or there's just no vibe at all. You're not coming on at all. Like, you're not even trying to come on. Like, there was no happy medium. It was no energy. But today was fun. Today was cute. I liked it. It restored my hope. I'm still not trying to meet too many people, but it did restore my hope, because I was at the point where it's just nobody in LA for fun. I was at the point where it's nobody in LA. But today was good. It's 11 o'clock. Gotta go to work tomorrow. Finna go to bed.
Child, okay. So I'm here. I've been ripping and running literally all day because, so we're doing the little shoot thing for, like I was telling y'all, I think I told y'all that basically my friend's friend, she had a campaign with the store REI, and she asked me to be a part of it. So I just got here, but I've been ripping and running because I left my shoes at home. So I had to go home during my lunch break, come back. I'm tired. Now I'm here. I'm waiting for them to get here. And this is a shirt that I had picked out, because I don't even think I even showed y'all the stuff I had got. But I basically, she had gave us a gift card to pick out some stuff, but I think I told y'all this. So I got this shirt, which is cute.
Yep.
Yeah, that's exactly how I feel right now. Mood. But yeah, so I got this shirt, but it's crazy. Like, why? This shirt was $38. Why? Girl, I got this hat. This is like, you know, an actual like workout hat, like post a block UV rays. This hat was like $38. No, this hat was $29. And then I got this hat, this Patagonia hat. And this hat was, how much is that? Okay, this hat was $35. I don't know why this stuff's so expensive, because I don't, especially not this t-shirt. This t-shirt wasn't given. It, no, it's not giving. But I don't even think I want to wear a hat. I think I'm going to just go bald. And then I bought my Chacos. And I'm going to wear these little khaki shorts. So that's the vibe that I'm trying to give. I don't know, though. It is hot, so I might wear a hat. Might not. I don't know. But y'all, not ripping and raining. Not razzled and shrazzled and flazzled. And now my stomach hurt. And the crazy part is, I don't know why my stomach is really hurting right now. And that be the part that really be getting on my nerves. Like, I understand when my stomach hurt when I done ate crazy. All I had today was some strawberries, some granola, a Caesar salad wrap that I made myself. Unless it's just because I be cooking and I just don't need to cook. A chicken Caesar salad wrap, and some of them little popcorn chips. That's it, Sway. So really, I don't really see what up in that concoction. Oh, and I had some green juice. It could be the green juice. It was extra green today. So it could be that, but I don't know. Stomach hurt. I'm feeling all razzle, dazzle, spazzle, clazzled and clazzled. And honestly, I'm ready to go lay down. Well, okay. I'm ready to do the shoot. And then I'm ready to go lay down. Work was cool. Work was chill. But I don't know. I'm just feeling very razzle dazzle, and I'm here on time. Well, actually, I'm a little early. She sold us the meat here at 6:15. It's 5:53. So I'm finna like, you know, get my chakras in order. Yeah. And I got some very important conversations I feel like I need to have with some people, because I just feel like I had found this post yesterday, and it's actually, I'm gonna insert it right here. But the post literally describes how I feel in my life right now. Cause I do feel like it's just this specific person. Like they be playing with me, but then they don't be playing with me. And I just don't understand it. And I really don't even want to, because I feel like I'm having to over communicate at this point. And it's the shit just not aligning. It's not doing the way I need it to do. And it's irritating me, but I enjoy the person. And the people, I enjoy the people, I enjoy the people, but I'm just tired of feeling like the way I be feeling, like when stuff happens, because they don't handle things correctly, or they don't, yeah, they just don't handle things correctly for me. And if I'm involved, y'all know I must always safeguard my feelings. So yeah, we'll see. So that's all. Stop me here. I'm about to. How you lay this thing back for a second? So this is just a quick PSA. I really just had to let y'all know that Beyonce is coming back on my birthday. And I feel like that means that this year is going to be amazing. Literally, Beyonce decided to drop whatever she dropped in Renaissance. You know what I'm saying? I think it was 16 songs or 12 songs, however many songs. On my birthday. So I feel like this is going to be my chosen year. And you know, y'all can't really say that. A lot of y'all can't say that. Some of y'all can, but like none of y'all really can. So a lot of y'all can't really live that life. So I feel like my year is now christened. Yeah.